A Capstone Design course in chemical engineering is sparking students' entrepreneurial drive. In this new course, students take an early-stage, commercially viable lab technology and develop a plan to get it to market.
We worked with teamwork, we worked with product development, we worked in the lab, we worked with the university community, we worked on building relationships. So the combination of all of that really allowed your engineering expertise to shine through and help foster more innovation.
Everyone knows that fuel economy is big now, so both aircraft and automobile manufacturers are actually looking into using lighter components, and one of the leading materials is actually composites made out of polymeric resins with carbon fiber reinforcements. These are non-conductive materials, and that actually creates some difficulties because you can actually build enough charge that it actually can interfere with communications and sensor electronics that are throughout the plane.
The PolyDrop project started with a professor and a graduate student. They got this great idea that if I can make nanowires, make them electrically conductive, then maybe I could put them into like a paint to create static dissipation.
Currently what they're doing right now to help dissipate static charge that builds up is they have a copper metal mesh that's embedded into the fuselage. And if that could potentially be removed by having a viable conductive coating, that enables more efficient fuel savings as well as less carbon dioxide emissions.
The advantage of going with this approach is that you can actually add very, very small quantities of this additive and still have adequate conductivity to dissipate static charge.
We wrote our reports and we went and we applied for the funding. Because if you don't have money to do your research, you don't have a project.
This Capstone funding helped us to build a prototype that successfully proved that we met the requirements for electrostatic dissipation. And that's a huge deal because that is the whole purpose of this product was to prove that that was possible. So the Capstone funding really enabled us to meet our goals.
Team PolyDrop took their successful prototype to the Environmental Innovation Challenge, a UW science and business competition. For PolyDrop, it was a natural fit with their Capstone project.
Basically, the name of the game is talk to judges, make sure they leave knowing what you do, why you do it, how it's good for the environment, share the idea behind that with the judge.
It actually allows the student to get some significant coaching on what it takes to actually develop a new venture.
Winning the Environmental Innovation Challenge was also incredible.
They started getting calls from all kinds of interested companies or early stage investors wanting to learn more about the technology. It actually sparked the entrepreneurial instinct in some of these students, kind of like a turning point from something that was a hypothetical company and venture that they were exploring to something that could be real.
It has definitely changed my future plans. I'm going to continue PolyDrop and work on it after I graduate. We're really excited about building PolyDrop into a company. So seeing that whole broad spectrum of development and research and then taking that and creating a product that can actually be usable in different markets and industries is something that you don't get with other Capstone projects.
On behalf of the students and the faculty, I would say sincerely thank you because of the opportunity that they've given the students to essentially learn in an environment that would not be accessible to them without that sort of investment.
As I prepare to graduate college, I realize that most of my success has been due to the platform of other people investing in my life. And so this has been really important. It's been one of those instances, and I really can't say thank you enough.